Hello, my name's Adrian Richards. I'm a plastic surgeon and I'm the medical director of Aurora Clinics. And today I'm going to be talking a little bit about Botox and treatment and how does it physically work. So Botox, as I mentioned in a previous video, is a protein released from the bacteria, the Clostridium botulinum bacteria, which is present in nature. Okay. So each of the different types of Botox work in essentially the same way. Nerves travel basically from the brain to where they're going to action, and the way they work is the nerve end and the muscle or the sweat gland are separated, and they use a transmitter which is secreted in little sort of balloon packages which travel between the two. So the nerve fires off these little particles which then tell the muscle or the sweat gland to fire off and produce either sweat or contract the muscle. And the neurotransmitter, the substance used in the balloons, in this case it's called acetylcholine. It's acetylcholine, a bit of a long name, a bit of a mouthful, but that's unfortunately what it is. And the Botox basically prevents release of these little particles from the nerves. So the nerves can't secrete the neurotransmitter, so then the muscle or sweat gland aren't getting any signals to either secrete sweat or contract. So the acetylcholine affects the nerves, but the nerves do recover, and after 3 to 4 months for muscle, or 6 months in case of sweat glands, the nerves will recover to their full activity. So it is reversible. So that's essentially how Botox works. Any nerves which don't use acetylcholine for their neurotransmitter won't be affected by Botox treatment. And these are the sort of smooth muscles, other muscles in the body won't be affected. If the Botox is injected over a nerve or away from the muscle or the sweat gland, there won't be any activity because it only affects the junction between the end of the nerve and the muscle, so any effects very locally. And the doses which are used in treatment of these conditions are minuscule and are very safe, although Botox is potentially dangerous substance when used in high concentrations. In the doses we're using, it's very, very safe. But that's one of the reasons you must go to a recognised practitioner, a respected practitioner who's using the proper Botox in very safe, secure environment. So I hope that's clarified a little bit of how Botox works. If you have any questions or queries about Botox or any other treatments we offer at Aurora Clinics, please don't hesitate to contact us either via the website or by ringing us on 01844 214 362. Thank you very much.